Hello, I'm Todd Lewis from Fiasco Sports, reporting for the SA Footballer magazine. Today I'm joined by Division 5 Rosewater president Chris Coles, and he's our feature president of the week. So Chris, tell us a little bit about yourself. Where did you grow up playing footy? What made you fall in love with the game?
I started footy later in my life. I more played soccer when I was young, and my first game of footy was basically when I was in the army. And you know, I just found a love for it, and I found that the physical side of things was really good in football. So, as I said, I was in the army, so I played in for Brunswick in Victoria. Then when I came over to South Australia, I then joined a country team, Mount Pleasant, played for Salisbury, and then I finished my career at Seton, where I done my shoulder. So, that's my football background.
Yeah, so how did you find the differences of style in... You say you've played in the country a little bit, you played at Seton, which is a bit more metropolitan. How did you find footy back in the day at different kinds of metropolitan and country level, and how do you see it, how it's transitioned into today?
I found that when I played footy, it was a much harder game, you know, and much to the AFL's credit, they're trying to stamp a lot of things out of the, you know, the things that were legal back then that aren't legal now, they're stamping it out, which is a good thing. I found it to be a harder game back when I played.
Okay, so how'd you transition into becoming a president? What was the, I guess, defining factor in you joining Rosewater as well? Because you obviously didn't play at the club, so what made you want to turn this club into a good place to be, I guess?
Well, I started my my time at Rosewater Football Club coaching juniors, Todd. I coached 5 years at the juniors, and I got my umpire's ticket, and I was asked last, well, 2 years I've been umpiring, and last year the treasurer slash secretary at the time, he said, you know, I'd like to nominate you to be the president. And I said, okay, I accept your nomination, not thinking that anything would happen from it. But yeah, and here I am as the president now, so that's how that's happened.
Yeah, so obviously you've only been in the role a pretty short time. How have you found it being the president of a football club? It's obviously a pretty large role. I know being involved at a football club, the president has a lot of duties. They're basically what holds the whole thing together. How have you found that?
I found it is... It's a full-on job. It's a full-on job. Lucky my business runs itself, because I have found I'm at this club a lot. I'm there every night, and you know, and unfortunately my wife's a junior president, so you know we're sort of dedicated to the Rosewater Football Club this year. But I have a good committee. I have a good strong committee behind me, and that makes a difference. And we have great volunteers as well. So yeah, that makes a difference.
Yeah. So. Off-field and on-field, what are your goals for this football club? Do you have any sort of short-term goals and long-term goals for where you want to see the football club?
My short-term goals, and you know that would coincide with my long-term goals, is Rosewater's always had that stigma attached to it that, you know, it's a rough club, and we can still get a lot of people, you know, call us ferals and things like that, and that's not the case. We work hard to, you know, to stamp all that out. We make people feel welcome, and it's, you know, like we have a lot of policies in place just to make sure that, you know, people know where they stand with the club.
So. Yeah, that's good. So I'll just ask you a little bit, is there any major sponsors you'd like to mention from the club that really support and make this club run on a day-to-day basis, and also if there's any club functions coming up that you'd like to mention?
Yeah, we've got a few sponsors. Our major sponsor is Portside Mitsubishi. We've got Adelaide Orthopaedics, ARM Bitumen, John Reardon Financial Services. My company sponsors as well. That's Jagger Services. We've got Carla Pauls. You know, I could go on. There's quite a few. And this year we've got our 130th year ball. That's the 4th of July, and you know that's something we're trying to make sure we sell the tickets to cover that, because it's a big thing for us, 130 year ball. Yeah.
Yeah. That seems like a major event. So I'm Todd Lewis from Fiasco Sports, reporting for the SA Football Magazine. I've been joined by Division 5 Rosewater President Chris Coles, and he was our feature president of the week.